your boy JT coming to you live. Just doing a quick update on my 90-gallon reef tank. This tank's been through it all. Just about everything, cyanobacteria, I had a flatworm outbreak, freshwater ick. I mean, not freshwater, saltwater ick. Diatom bloom, green hair algae bloom. Just about everything. We have one boil, it's dying. It's been dying for months now. But part of it, I kept it in there because part of it is still kind of there. Trying to make it a comeback, I don't know. It's not all the way completely dead, so. We'll see if we can save it. If not, that's okay. We'll leave it if we'll get some for calcium. It's not calcium, but. Everything else is looking great. So is it doing good? So is it like this? Donut coil is going good. My bubble coil took a dump and died, and actually left it in there. And matter of fact, trying to make something come back, kind of crazy. So if you got bubble tip corals, just leave it in there, even though it's dead skeleton, it came back somehow. So hopefully that grows into something else, maybe kind of awesome. I do have some acros up there. It's doing pretty good, surprisingly. Guys got plenty of room to swim and plenty of cave to hide out if they want to. I know some people don't believe in this type of system, but I personally like it and it works well for what I do. Aqua caving, aqua escaped it. Shit kind of like rocks in there. I'll go with a brief leash system. I don't use a filter stock anymore. It's kind of ghetto rig, but I got a doser over there, and I'm doing 4-part calcium, alkalinity, sodium, and trace elements. It's all getting added to the tank. Also have all the top off system. Running to a 25-gallon reservoir. So, but tank condition is super stable. Everything's doing great. So, I don't know. It is what it is. It's your boy out. One more time. Thank you.